I'm here with Jim DeCandolo, who's the promoter for the show today. Jim, so how long you've been working with Mainline?
We started our business in 1980. I was a senior in high school. We started a company. It was a small-time business, part-time business on the side. And we've been doing shows ever since then. It's become a much bigger business recently, and I started doing it full-time about 6 years ago.
How many shows do you do a year?
We promote just one, but we set up at about 12, 13, 14 shows a year.
Excellent. What do you like about the Pittsburgh show?
I've been coming to the Pittsburgh show. The previous promoter, Jeff Stogner, started it in 1988. I did every one as a vendor, missed one when I got married. I purchased it from Jeff 5 years ago. We just like coming to Pittsburgh. We're from Philadelphia. We enjoy the restaurants. We enjoy the area. We look forward to, it used to be twice a year. Now it's only once a year. It used to be spring and fall. Now it's only the spring. At this university, we had to stop having a fall show due to they moved their football team. Used to play off campus, and now they play on campus. And due to home football games, it was very hard to schedule a show in the fall. So it was moved to one time a year. But just love coming to Pittsburgh. We've developed a very loyal customer base and a very friendly area and a very collector-centric customer base.
What's your favorite thing about working with the athletes here? I see a lot of them in the background kind of going in and signing product back there. And
It's a lot of the guys that I grew up watching, we try to bring in a good mix of athletes, of hockey, football, baseball players. Obviously, the Penguins are very big in this area. We always try to bring in some Penguins. We bring in football Hall of Famers. We bring in Steelers. We bring in baseball Hall of Famers. But busy downstairs running around, but I get to, you know, say hi to some of the athletes and, you know, thank them for coming and, you know, appreciate what they did on the fields when I was watching them as a younger guy.
Now, I noticed it seems to be a family affair. I actually met your son and he connected me to you as we were getting here, so.
Yes, my brother is my partner. I'm sorry, my partner is my brother. We're co-promoters and we run our business together. To put on a show here to where we bring in 30 some plus athletes, you need a lot of help. The school provides volunteers, but I have a lot of good help and they come from far away. You know, they all drive 5 hours. I have two sons that come out with me. They're driving age now. My wife comes out, has a very busy schedule, but you know, she comes out and supports our business and is here for the weekend, has got to drive back tomorrow night, you know, so it's 5-6 hour drive each way. My kids are interested, one's interested in baseball, one's interested in football, so they're out here, they're interested in the business, interested in, not as much in the hobby as my brother and I have, but they're just out here to support us, and I have some very good friends that have come out, and it can't be done without all their help.
Excellent. Now, I'm assuming you're a collector yourself?
I am a collector. I collect less and less. I have
What's your favorite piece?
I have a Sports Illustrated collection. I collect autographed Sports Illustrated, so I probably have about 2,000 different. And I've just put away, and I still add to it every now and then. I collect a few other things. I've been a collector my whole life. As I got a little bit older, sort of other things to take up my time. So I probably just don't collect as much as I did it, but I still have my collection put aside.
So what's next for the future of the show?
Unfortunately, for us, Robert Morris, their growth, their popularity, especially in their the success in their basketball program, they would like to expand this building we're in, which we've been in for 30 some plus years, the Sewell Center. They're expanding it, it's renovating it, and it will not be available for this show next year. And when it is finished, they won't have the square footage to provide us with what we need. So we're going to move to Monroeville, Pennsylvania, a large convention center. It's about 40 minutes east of here. We're going to try to run the exact same type of show, and hopefully the diehards from this area of Pittsburgh, hopefully they'll come out there, and hopefully we'll pick up more customers from the central and eastern Pennsylvania. We're 40 miles east here, still obviously Pittsburgh, but you get a little closer to Harrisburg and the Philadelphia area. And even being out here, we draw a lot of people from Ohio, New York. We've had people come from Florida and Texas. My first customer today was from California. So in Monroeville, we're a little further from the airport, which complicates things, bringing athletes in a little, complicates my job a little bit, just being further from the airport. But hopefully we'll get our customer base to continue to go to the show out there.
And just out of curiosity, you were talking about, you know, athletes coming from afar. You and I were talking when we were in the elevator. You've got some athletes that are coming from international locations.
Yeah, we try to meet the, I'll say, demands of our customers who are diehard collectors. And whether you're a 71 Pirates fan, 79 to the 2 years they won the World Series, or you collect baseball cards, sets, and everything. We brought in three guys from Venezuela. I'm sorry, Tony Armas, Vic Davalio, and Manny Sarmiento. Frank Tavares came from the Dominican Republic, and the three guys, with what's going on in society of Venezuela now, lots of internal strife and inflation and internal conflict, we're, you know, crossing our fingers that they could make it, and elated that they did make it. I believe they had a good time. Excuse me, they got to meet up with a lot of, you know, people they haven't seen in a long time, ex-ball players they got to meet, run into. They went to the Pirates game last night, so I think everything worked out well. I know they did a lot of traveling, and I hope they enjoyed themselves.
Good. Well, thank you very much for taking the time, and I wish you luck.
Well, thank you very much. It's a pleasure.